Hello everyone. Today we're going to do grade 6 and this is module 3 and this is the first session. Today's session is about Neerja Bhanot. The name of the chapter is also Neerja Bhanot, Brave in Life, Brave in Death. So this story is about the flight attendant Neerja Bhanot who was killed during a plane hijack while she was trying to rescue the passengers. To start off this session, what we're going to do is we're going to tell them the story through different newspaper articles and notes about Neerja Bhanot. So before the class starts, you can display all these articles around in the classroom. Maybe tie a twine and just display all these different articles about Neerja Bhanot. And what we do is at the same time play this audio of her her last recording from the flight that she had taken and where she was killed. So the audio will be played where she's giving instructions to her passengers, and while this is happening, we'll also be going around seeing these articles and reading them, and also you can tell the children to get information from these articles. Now after they do that, what they're going to do is the students are going to come together and sit in a large circle, and they're going to take a bottle and spin the bottle. So when you spin the bottle will be pointing to one person, so that person is going to be the person who's going to answer a question. And the bottle will be facing another person, and that person has to frame a question. Now that person has to frame a question based on what he just read in the class. So even before the activity starts, you can tell them to make sure to note down points from these different articles they are reading. So then this will be helpful to frame questions while they are sitting in a circle. So every time the bottle is being spun, the person who the bottle points to has to answer the question, and the other side, whoever is sitting on the other side of the bottle, has to ask the question. So this will go on, and different people will be asking questions to different the others in the class, and they will be giving the answers. And if at all the student is not able to answer, he can get help from the others as well. So this is going to be how we are going to introduce the character Neerja Bhanot to the class. And this is the opening. Now to move on to the main creation, we are going to do this activity to help them understand meanings. Now for this activity, you have two handouts. So this is the first handout. What you're going to do is you're going to split the class into pairs. Okay, and the first person in the pair gets the handout, which has different sentences. Now if you see, every sentence has one word in bold and it's also underlined. What they're going to do is the student has to find out the meaning to that word. Now there will be another handout which you're going to give the other student in the pair. So you give the other handout to the other person, and what they do is when the first person reads out a sentence, they will read out three options. For example, Neerja Bhanot was a flight attendant for Pan Airlines based in Mumbai, India. Now what the other person has to do is going to read the first three sentences or the first three options. A person employed to provide a service to the public is the first option. Second is happy, and the third is cheerful. Now this first student has to figure out which word or which option of these three was the meaning. So I hope that is clear. There's a sentence and the one word is in bold, and the first person will read out the sentence, the other person will give out three meanings, and the first person has to guess which is the right meaning. Now these are very, very simple, because words like happy and cheerful are clearly not what attendant means. So they will be able to figure out what meaning is appropriate in what word. So the second person cannot give the answer, though the second person knows the answer, because that's also in bold. The second person cannot help the first person. They have to read out all the options, and the first person has to guess which one is the meaning. So first person reads a sentence, the second person gives three options of meanings, and the first person again guesses which one is the right meaning to the word that is in bold. So I hope that is clear. So the student, the pairs will, there are 12 sentences, so pairs will do all the 12 sentences. And this will be the first part of main creation, where they are going to get familiar with different meanings for different words. Now for the second part of the main creation, what we are going to do is we are going to play a game of dumb charades. Now for playing dumb charades, remember that these are again words that were done in the previous activity. So the meaning of the words they had learned in the previous activity, where we are giving them options and making it very easy for them to understand meanings. Now for dumb charades again, what they are going to do is they are going to take these words and they are going to they're going to act it out, and the other class is going to guess. So within your manual itself, we have given a bunch of words. Now you can split the class with two or three based on your strength of your class. One person from every team comes up, will act it out, and the other team members have to guess. Now these are not easy words. Remember, these are all a little complicated words. Like we have words like cockpit, attendant, distressed, then pilot. So what why we've given these words is because these are the words with the meanings that are already given in the previous activity. So tell the students to remember what they learned in the previous activity and then enact it. So for example, attendant, they do have a meaning in the previous activity itself, and they have to recollect what they learned and enact it out. Now before they get into this activity, you or the facilitator can also help them with these meanings and give them examples and ideas of what these meenings are. So then during the dumb charades, it will be easier for them to enact it out. So since these are little complicated words, facilitator can give them little tips and help them with these word meanings, and then let them enact it, and the others can guess what the word is. This is going to be the second part of the meaning creation. Another third part of the meaning creation is where they're going to frame sentences. So this is called find your place. So what you're going to do is there is a sheet of with different sentences. So again, the class is split into around 5 to 6 teams based on the number of sentences. Now what you do is you have to cut out every sentence into different words. So the worksheet already has different sentences, and every word will be one card. So what you do is give every card to one student. So one word will have only one card. Sorry, one card will have only one word that you give to one student. The second person will get a second card with another word. The third student will get a third card with another word. Now you have to remember that these words can come together to form a sentence. So for example, if the sentence is my name is Sneha, one person will have the word my, second person will have the word name, the third person will have the word is, and the fourth person will have the word Sneha. But the students don't know the order, so you're just going to randomly give out these cards. Now students have to come together and form these sentences and stand in the right order. So the first sentence, so when you say the first sentence, that 5 students have to come in front and stand, and each person has to say it out loud. So first person will say my, the second person will say name, third will say is, the fourth person will say Sneha. So that way every person is going to say the word, and they're going to frame the entire sentence. So I hope that is clear. They're going to use one word, and they're going to come together and frame the entire sentence and tell it out to the class. And the class can judge if they're right or wrong. If they're wrong, they will again rearrange them in a way that they are right. So make sure they're all standing in that order as per the sentence. So this is the last part of the meaning creation. Now for closure, what you're going to do is you're going to tell the students to recollect any brave thing that they have done in their life. So for this activity, you have to also tell them about what Neerja Bhanot did and how she was, her act of bravery is still remembered in the country and even in the world. So ask them what is the brave thing that you've done, and tell them to recall any little, even if it's a small thing, it doesn't matter. But what is something that they're really proud of themselves, what something that they have done in the past. So tell them to write it down, or even they can draw pictures and represent what this one thing that they did. And after this, what you do is you tell them to go around in their school or in their neighborhood when they go back home and collect stories of bravery. So this is an at-home activity or in school activity, it can be either one of that. So they can go around, ask students, or in the weekend if they go home, they can ask their parents or their relatives or neighbors, and they have to note down different acts of bravery or different stories of bravery from different people, and they have to get 3 to 4 stories. Again, they can write it down as a story, or they can even draw pictures and represent the stories that they are collecting. But they all have to come up with 3 to 4 stories, and they have to bring it in the following week. So this will be their closure, and you will also be explaining their at-home activity. And this is how we will end the first session of Module 3. Thank you.
Your phone vibrated 2-3 times. Yeah.